I'm here with a man who ensures that the artists, when they go on stage, are well looked after. Hopefully not too well oiled, but well catered for. I'm with MacDara Lamb. MacDara, how are you? How is the
good,
evening?
Good, good.
You're enjoying the festival.
It's hard work.
Almost over.
Almost over. Everybody's in.
You have a very unusual job. Now, some people think that it's a very easy job, but I presume there's a few hidden dangers in it. Your job is basically managing the green room, looking after the artists, making sure that all their needs are catered for.
Yeah, the top artists would have a rider sent in, which would be what they'd want in their dressing room, you know, right. And we do our best to accommodate them.
And you have a team of three that helps you.
I have a team of three there, yeah.
Now, have you ever got any weird or mad requests from some of these people?
Not here, but
other places.
Other places, yeah. Well, it wouldn't be mad, you know.
Like, we hear stories about people like who want all the blue M&Ms removed from their packets before they're served.
I wouldn't know, I think it's a bit of a myth, but maybe if they're huge bands, I don't know, you know.
You hear some then, of course, who want special mineral waters left for them and things like that. Do you get that type of thing?
Some artists would be traveling from America and they'd be. You want specialist products, someone don't have dietary requirements, different things.
Some of them prima donnas, like they just want, they demand exactly the best of everything.
Well, I would never, I haven't met the prima donnas, some people can be demanding, but that's just the way it is.
Now, our readers may know, our viewers, I should say, may notice there's a striking resemblance in your persona here, and maybe we should tell them, of course, that MacDara Lamb is, in fact, the son of Tin Lizzy's Phil Innitt. So that's something you've grown up with all through the years, and there is a striking resemblance, of course.
It's kind of not something that I've grown up with all the years. I found out about 10 years ago. Only about 10 years ago. Yeah.
And how did you react to that?
Jaw dropping. It took a while to get it.
Did you get your head around it?
I went looking for my parents and went to the orphanage. I met my mum, and just before I met her, this came to light, and I don't know, he's gone, so we just built myself and my mother just built on our relationship. It was just one side of it,
I mean, some people do go and they eventually find out who their parents were or the father or whatever, but to find out that he was a rock legend, I mean, I'm going back to the late 60s and I remember Phil. I met him on several occasions myself, saw him on the street. I wasn't his buddies or anything with him, but I met people who used to just go down to bus stops to watch him getting on the bus and follow him around town because he was a rock legend. Well, you can see that in Dublin now. They built a statue in his memory and put a bronze statue up. Have you been up there?
Oh yeah, of course. I mean, he is a legend. Yeah, that's not without doubt. But
your association with the music business, maybe that's in the genes that it's come through in some way.
I don't know. I think it's by chance more than anything else.
Well, I know that your hidden passion, of course, is you're a sculptor.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you want to tell me a little bit about that?
I don't know. I started off. I did this sculpting in Kildare stone years and years ago, and then as a hobby I just started doing a piece of bog oak, and it's kind of done a couple of exhibitions now. And
you've done exhibitions? Any major ones planned?
None plans, kind of. I had one there at Christmas in the museum in Galway, and I don't know, I need to get back into the shed and need time, I had a son there 2 years ago, Rory, and since kind of everything got put into the shed and stopped. So
what age is he?
He's two. Just over two. Yeah, two.
Does he know about Phil and his granddad?
Ah, granddad, yeah. Of course.
That's great. You're going through the old albums and things like that.
Yeah, it's kind of strange. Yeah, I've started playing, I suppose, a bit to him and listening a bit more myself from some of the older stuff that you wouldn't have. More obscure stuff.
That's brilliant. That's a great history. Well, any more festivals throughout the year now? You've got to look after more artists?
I don't know. I do. It's kind of, you take different jobs at festivals. You don't get to do this at them all. I do different things on different festivals. Hopefully,
back to what I was saying earlier about looking after the artists and some of their peculiar demands, perhaps. But, you're actually giving free drink to them as well, is it?
Yeah.
Do you have to watch that? They're going on stage. and they might just get an extra few. Or do you take the bottle away? Or
and you wouldn't. You can't take. Well, you kind of sometimes wait till they've played to then put in all the heavier spirits. More so.
Do you water them down?
God, no. But some artists then don't even drink, but. Yeah, might gargle a brandy or something before they go on stage for their throat, and you know, there's different people have different requirements.
Different folks for different strokes. But look at Mac Dyer. I hope you enjoy the rest. You've got this night to go, and then it's a big wrap up.
Big takedown tomorrow.
Get up
in the morning, take it down, and then tomorrow night might go out and have a few pints. All right, yeah.
Well, look at it. Absolutely lovely sitting and having a chat. Just a nice relaxing chat.
All right, pleasure.
And
thank you.
Really all have right, a great cheers. Time. Nice. That was Mac Dyer Lamb, the son of Phil Linnett, who is looking after all the artists here at the Temple House Festival.